What's up, YouTube? This is Too Raw for TV. Alright, so before I get into this video, I want to give a big shout out to the brother Instinct Takes for the $5 donation via the Cash App. Much respect to Instinct Takes, a longtime subscriber and a longtime contributor to Too Raw for TV, aka Too Raw for Sports. Alright. So, oh, and before I forget, if you don't know this, my other channel, Too Raw for Sports, the original one, I'm no longer able to access that channel. The videos are still available to watch, though. I'm no longer able to access that channel, so I had to create a secondary channel, Too Raw for Sports. The difference is, it's a dollar sign at the end instead of an S. I'll put a link to that channel in the pinned comment. In the comment section below. Alright, there's a link to the channel. It's going to be a link to the channel in the pinned comment in the comment section below. Alright. This goddamn James Harden, man. As soon as we praise this nigga, praise him for having a bounce back season. Because he has been. He's been balling, man. You know, that's why I ain't really be, you see I ain't been making no videos about him choking against great teams. He had been showing up. He had been balling, hitting big shots. It's reflected in his numbers. Last year, he shot 40% from the floor. This year, he was shooting better than 45%, or is shooting better than 45%. Last year, he only shot 33% from beyond the range, from three-point range. This year he was approaching 40% from three-point range. I mean, having one of his best seasons ever shooting the basketball. And, you know, and also he just looks sharper, more energetic. He's more aggressive. And also, I don't see him crying as much about calls. Last year, you know, he was struggling a bit shooting the basketball, putting up points. So he was crying a lot about calls. This year he's only averaging a little over six free throw attempts per game. But he's still getting his points because, to me, he looks a little bit more like, in the way that he's scoring, he looks a little bit more like Kevin McHale era James. Yes, he's shooting the three. Yes, the step back three is still going to be a part of his game until he finishes this game. But he's starting to mix it up more. You see him sometimes even post up a little bit. You see him going to the hole. And that was always James Harden's game before he became too infatuated with the step back and getting calls. But anyway, against the Boston Celtics, James Harden laid a goddamn egg. Lay the motherfucking egg. And, you know, look, man. I know it's just one game. But this has been his M.O. This has been his M.O. throughout his career. That when he plays against elite talent or elite teams, he folds. Now, against Memphis, the other day, I think he had 31 points. He looked sensational. Tonight, well, last night, 5 of 16 from the floor, 2 of 7 from three-point range, 4 turnovers, not impactful at all. Now, you can just say it's just one game and shit, man, but when you notice that he do this against the best teams, that's when you start becoming a little bit concerned. Now, I know every damn game you play against a great team, he's not going to play like crap. But, you know, you just notice there's a pattern with James Harden that when you need him to give him, when you need him to give you his most, he gives you his least. So this is the year where you got to see whether he breaks that pattern. And I'm actually rooting for James Harden. As much as I've shitted on James Harden in the past, I'm rooting for him to break that pattern. Because everybody think I'm a damn hater. I'm not a damn hater. I just tell the truth from my perspective. I want this dude to be successful. Now I want to win a championship, because that'll mean either the Bulls or the Bucks haven't won. But I wouldn't mind him getting to a conference finals and playing well. Just to break that, you know, because I think if he does it again this year, I think the gloves are coming off from the media. You know, if he has a great regular season, but then he goes in the playoffs and he plays like shit, I think the media is going to give it to him this time. I don't think it's going to be the kid gloves approach. Cause I think they kind of running out of excuses to keep doing that shit. James, you got to bring it against these great teams, bro. You can't... I mean, I'm not trying to nitpick, bro, but when you're going up against the best teams or the marquee teams, you just tend to not be effective, bro. Like, I'm struggling remembering when the last time James Harden had a big game against an elite team. Think about it. I'm really struggling to remember that shit. Like, even that 35-point game he had against the Warriors when they got eliminated in 2019, Game 6. Even that 35-point game, 30 of that shit came in three quarters. And I believe in the fourth quarter, he had 5 points and 4 turnovers. The last big game that comes to mind that he had against an elite team was when he had a 44-point game against the Warriors and hit the game winner. And that was like the Kevin Durant era. I'm sure he's had some decent games, but I just can't remember him having a big game against an elite team. I'm not talking about some 60-point triple-double against the Magic or a 50-point game against the Pelicans. I'm talking about some regular season shit. I'm talking about, or even in the regular season, I'm talking about him doing something against the Bucks or when the Warriors were championship material or when the Cavs were a championship team or, you know, I just can't remember. Celtics recently. Against the Sixers before he joined them. I just can't remember. But anyway, tell me what you guys think.